Hello everyone. So, do you ever have these moments that you feel like everything is turning into shit? Like for me, this was around when I was more or less 20 years old. So, 6 years ago. But first, I have to give you a bit of background. So, in high school, I was quite a good student, but I had one problem. I liked everything. I like to learn everything, every subject. I like science, I like history. So for me, it was very hard to figure out what I wanted to do when I grew up. And at the time, when you listen to your parents, they always tell you, oh, study something to have a good job, to earn a lot of money, so you have a good life. That's what they always tell you. And okay, so at that time, in high school, I studied science, so I tried to do a mechanical engineering course. And I went to university, and obviously, it didn't work out, because I didn't like some of the classes, I didn't like some of the friends that I was making there, because it was very competitive people, they just wanted to have good grades, and I started to have bad grades, obviously, because I didn't like the classes. And since I wasn't used to it, everything starts to fall apart. I'm in Lisbon, away from my home, and when I come back home, my family's tearing apart itself too, because my brother, I have a older brother, he went to France to work, my parents split up around that time, so everything seems that it was going wrong. And I had to give up on the course. So I went back home, and I didn't know what I wanted to do. I was so confused at that time. And I was asking to my friends, to my family, what should I do? And they, okay, try to a different approach. Do what you like. So if you were in a course that you didn't like, if you had classes that you didn't like, now try to do something that you like. And okay, so I was thinking, and what do I like? What do I like to do? And at the time, there was one thing that it made me very happy to be part of, which was an amateur theater group that I had with my friends from my hometown. We started that group when we went to high school, because some of us went to different schools, we went to different cities, so we created this group to be together. And, you know, it was a lot of fun. We were playing all the time. It was a bit more having fun than actually doing theater. We spent maybe one entire year to prepare a single play, so we were not very productive, but we had a lot of fun. We were always joking with each other, joking with our teacher. We had a teacher to help us with the play. So I thought, well, I love to do theater. I was quite good at it, actually. So I thought, okay, maybe I should study acting in university. And okay, I signed up for it, and I trained a bit for it. There was this special exams that I had to do. So I trained a bit for it, and I was very motivated and, you know, very hopeful that this is something that finally I would enjoy to do. And okay, the day comes, I go to the university, and it's this amazing university because it's arts and music university. So I was walking on the corridors, and you could hear people practicing like classical instruments like violin, trombone. It was so much different from the engineering university. And I was just in love with that. I was in heaven. And I get together with the other guys that were about to do the exam, and we talk a bit. And I remember perfectly, one girl, she was sitting next to me, and she was telling something like, oh, last year, I was so dumb. I signed up for these exams, and I only studied for 2 weeks before the exam. Oh, it was so bad. And then it all comes down on me. I only studied for 2 weeks for this exam. I'm screwed. And from this point, I was just thinking about, oh my God, I will not make it. I will fail this exam, because it was a lot of people for very few places. And I start to panic a bit, but okay, I'm there, so I will try my best. And first we do the theoretical exam. and I mean it is okay. Then we do the physical expression exam, and which is, it went quite well, you know, because it's about, you know, maybe a bit of talent and not so much of preparation, you know, it's to improvise and stuff, and it went quite well and I was feeling motivated again. But then it came the last one, which was the monologue. It was maybe a 3-page monologue, and I had all that time the girl saying, oh, I didn't practice enough. And I walk into the room, and there's like this huge room with a table on one top and three teachers sitting there looking at me, and like this empty room, so intimidating. And when I go in, I just think about the girl and I think about other people. That it was quite funny because some people were there for 15 minutes and other people were there for 5 minutes. So I was like, okay, if they don't like me, they will send me away. So it was so intimidating. And I start the monologue and it kind of goes okay, but halfway through it, with the nerves and, you know, the not preparing well, because I didn't prepare well, obviously, it goes downhill and I start to forget things and I try to, you know, improvise a bit and maybe mend things a bit. But then the guy just said, oh, okay, it's okay, you can stop. I was like, oh, okay, it's done. And the guy asked me, so what do you thought? And yeah, I don't think it was so good. Yeah, but why not? Because I forgot some things, you told me to stop. Oh yeah, but you know that how things work. Okay, thank you very much. And I go out of the room and I know that I wouldn't pass. So I go back home and we get the results the next days, and yeah, I failed that one. Actually, I had some good grades on the other exams, but that one, if you didn't pass that one, you didn't have a chance. So that was the experience for me. And now it would be the part that I would tell you the morale of the story or all the teachings that I had with it. But actually, it took some time for me to understand what happened, because after that, I was very sad that I didn't got into it. And I was back at square one again. I didn't know what I was about to do. So I just had to spend some time looking at, you know, university courses. I picked one almost randomly, and I think I was very, very lucky that I got into a very good class. I got to make very good friends, which helped me and which helped me to develop. And only after maybe a year or two, I looked back at the experience and trying to figure out what failed, you know. And I think for me, the different thing is that I like theater for what it represented to me, you know, to be with my friends, to playing with them, to joke around, to go to different places. And we were always motivating each other to practice the test. If I was doing a scene with one of them and they would know, I would, oh, come on, how you don't know this stuff? Come on, you have to study more. How you do not know this? We were always motivating each other. And when I started to try to practice for the exam, it was almost like a job, you know? So almost all the passion was gone. And, you know, after this, I realized that if you want something, you cannot always expect for it to come naturally to you. You have to fight for it. You have to work hard. You cannot always rely on passion or, you know, sweet feelings about it. So yeah, that was the experience. And you can say that after this, sometimes things do need to get into shit before they turn into gold. Thank you.